I'm sure some of you would be in contact with these three roll numbers: roll number 139, 144, and 160. Okay, you can ask them to directly talk to me, or you can ask them to watch this recording that we just started. Okay, the reason being, I want to show you something. Typically, I prefer not to show your classmates' assignment. I mean, yes, there are some mistakes in this assignment, okay, and something there are which are also correct. But the thing is, the reason I mentioned these three roll numbers. This one is roll number 160. This one is roll number 139. And this one is roll number 144. Okay, and all of these drawings are basically the same drawing. Okay, and what just has happened is the name and the roll number has been changed, and the photos have been taken, and they have been sent to me. Okay, so I'm planning on grading them. Distributing the marks equally. Okay. So if you have got 7.5 marks, so for these three students, I'm going to give you exactly 1/3 of that. Okay, I mean you can check whether that these are all the, you know, these are all the same drawing. Okay, it's the same drawing. Okay, so if you look at this corner over here, it's the same drawing. Okay, so if you want to, I mean, my message to the students is that if you want to pass this course, you better not be doing such things, and you should be drawing your own assignment. Okay. So I'm going to give them, just distribute their marks individually. Equally. I'll just divide the marks equally and give it to them for this assignment. Okay. So that is there. These are the things from my side, and now you can mention that if you have queries regarding the assignment that you have been given.
Sir, আরেকবার স্যার আলোচনা করবেন, মানে কিভাবে স্যার সেকশনটা ভাগ করব বুঝতেই পারছি না, মানে মুশকিল
কোন। আচ্ছা, এক্সিলেন্ট।
মানে ওই ছবিটা স্যার আরেকবার একটু মানে আলোচনা করবেন, মানে বুঝতেই খুব অসুবিধা হচ্ছে।
আচ্ছা, okay. Okay. So this was the drawing. Okay. Acha. Kon jinish section niye bujhte oshubidha hocche?
স্যার একবার স্যার আপনি ওই উপরেরটা বুঝিয়ে দেবেন স্যার, মানে যখন আঁকতে বসছি স্যার মানে সব ইয়ে হয়ে যাচ্ছে। এই কথা।
আচ্ছা, মানে কোন কম্পোনেন্টটা? কম্পোনেন্ট নাম্বার 11, এই
হ্যাঁ
হ্যান্ড
স্যার,
হুইলটা?
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, মানে স্যার আগের দিনও বুঝিয়েছিলেন স্যার, আমি অসুবিধা হচ্ছে।
আচ্ছা, তো এই হ্যান্ড হুইলটার কটা স্পোক আছে সেটা বুঝতে হবে। এর স্পোক আছে হচ্ছে টোটাল 6টা, আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি 1 2, দেন 1/2 অ্যান্ড আনাদার হাফ, সো টোটাল 3 আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি ওভার দা ওভার ওয়ান সাইড, দেন আনাদার 3 অন দি আদার সাইড। ওকে, তাহলে সো দ্য টপ ভিউ আই বিলিভ ইজ নট গোয়িং টু বি অ্যান ইস্যু। ওকে, সো দ্য ক্রস সেকশন ইজ এসেন্সিয়ালি অ্যান ইলিপস উইথ উইথ দ্য উইথ দ্য মেজর অ্যাক্সিস গোয়িং ওভার 18 মিলিমিটার্স অ্যাজ ইউ ক্যান সি ফ্রম হিয়ার, অ্যান্ড অ্যান্ড দ্য মাইনার অ্যাক্সিস ইজ আই বিলিভ 10। মাইনার অ্যাক্সিস ইজ 10। ওকে, নাও দ্যাট থিং ইউ অনলি হ্যাভ টু ড্র, দ্যাট থিং ইউ অনলি হ্যাভ টু ড্র ইন দ্য সেকশনাল ভিউ। ওকে, সো দ্যাট ইজ অল দেয়ার ইন দ্য সেকশনাল ভিউ। সেকশনাল ভিউতে তো আর কিছু নেই, সো ইউ বেসিক্যালি হ্যাভ ওকে, সো মানে সেকশন ভিউতে যেটা আমরা ফ্রন্ট ভিউটা দেখছি, সেখানে তো ইউ ক্যান ইমাজিন দেট ইজ এ রেক্টাঙ্গেল অফ লেন্থ 220 mm। ওকে, অ্যান্ড দ্য হাইট উড বি হাউ মাচ, 24। সো দিস মাচ ইজ 24, অ্যান্ড দ্য লেন্থ ইজ 220। ওকে, দেন ওভার হিয়ার ইটস অ্যাকচুয়ালি আ সেন্টার লাইন, সো দিস সাইড অফ দ্য রেক্টাঙ্গেল ইজ আ সেন্টার লাইন। ওকে, বাট ইউ অ্যাকচুয়ালি ডোন্ট, ওকে, সো দেন হোয়াট ডু ইউ ড্র ইজ ইউ হ্যাভ টু ড্র আ সার্কেল উইথ দ্য সেম ডায়ামিটার, সো 24 ইজ দ্য ডায়ামিটার অফ দ্য সার্কেল। ওকে, সো দ্যাট পার্ট ইজ দেয়ার। ওকে, অ্যান্ড দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু পুট হ্যাচ লাইন্স, অ্যান্ড ইটস অন দ্য সেম বডি, সো অন দ্য ইদার সাইড ইট ইজ ইট শুড বি এক্স্যাক্টলি দ্য সেম। আচ্ছা, ইন দ্য মিডল দ্য থিকনেস অফ দিস মিডল পোর্শন হুইচ বেসিক্যালি সিটস অন দ্য স্পিন্ডল ইজ হ্যাজ আ উইথ অর দ্য হাইট অফ 30 মিলিমিটার, সো ইউ ক্যান ইমাজিন ইন দ্য সেন্টার, সো লেটস সে দিস ইজ দ্য সেন্টার হুইচ ইজ দিস ওয়ান ইজ 220, সো দিস শুড বি 110, সো অ্যাবাউট দ্যাট ইউ ক্যান এগেন ইমাজিন আ রেক্ট্যাঙ্গেল হুইচ হ্যাজ 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 আ লেন্থ অফ 50। অন দ্য টপ ভিউ ইটস আ সার্কেল অফ 50 mm ডায়ামিটার, সো 25 ওভার হিয়ার অ্যান্ড 25 ওভার হিয়ার, দ্যাট ইজ সর্ট অফ আ রেক্ট্যাঙ্গেল। ওকে, সো জাস্ট ড্র দ্যাট রেক্ট্যাঙ্গেল, অ্যান্ড ইফ ইউ আর ড্রয়িং দ্যাট রেক্ট্যাঙ্গেল ইউ শুড অলসো ইট ইজ দিস পোর্শন অফ দ্য উইল। ওকে, দ্যাট উড নট বি ভিজিবল। ওকে, বাট দেন দের আর স্পোকস গোয়িং ফ্রম দ্য, সো দ্যাট পার্ট, দ্যাট রেক্টাঙ্গুলার পোর্শন, দিস ওয়ান অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইজ কল্ড দ্য হাব, সো দিস ওয়ান ইজ দ্য হাব, অ্যান্ড দিস ইউ নো টরয়েডাল শেপ, টরয়েডাল মিন্স লাইক লাইক এ ডোনাট। ওকে, দিস টরয়েডাল পোর্শন ইজ কল্ড দ্য রিং, সো টু রিপ্রেজেন্ট দ্য হাব পোর্শন okay, so you actually show the spokes coming out of the hub, okay, and in that spoke somewhere along the length of the spoke, you actually show an elliptical cross section, which is a rotated cross section. So again, you need to draw the center line for that, and that you can make a hand drawing, but just ensure that the width remains 18. Thickness, of course, is 10 because that is what is the thickness of the spoke. Okay, and again, the section, the hatch lines in the same direction. Now, there is some change, and that change is this rectangle. Okay, is only rectangle up to this part. Okay, you have to understand the spokes are essentially cylinders. Okay, and that is a cylinder in this direction. Okay, so about this axis, the spokes are cylinder, which is a horizontal axis, and the hub is a cylinder along the vertical axis. So when they connect, the connection happens, okay, over a curved surface. So you can put a reasonably arbitrary curve. Okay, so this curved portion is just a reasonably arbitrary curve. Okay, and then what happens next is the 24 millimeter is the width of that portion of the spindle that goes inside the handwheel. So you need to make that hollow 24 millimeter portion by drawing these two solid lines, which is the geometry outline, thick lines, and then again put sectional lines or hatch lines to represent that this is a section. Okay, so this is with the front view, and the top view is essentially what has been drawn right there. Okay, right there, but on either side. So on the top view, so for to draw the top view, you need to drop the projection lines to the, so this is what you get on the vertical plane. Okay, and in order to draw that on the horizontal plane, you need to draw these projection lines. Okay, so then draw a couple of center lines intersecting in the middle. Okay, then the first thing you should do is with the outermost diameter, draw a circle. Okay, and that would represent the outer surface of the rim. Okay, and then another circle. Now these are all thin lines, these are projection lines. This right there is a thick line representing an outline of the solid geometry. Okay, then again with this diameter, draw another circle, and that completes your rim portion. Okay, now for the hub, again draw a circle. Okay, for the interior of the hub, extend these lines 24 millimeter, and again draw a circle. Okay, and then you need to draw the rims. Okay, which are essentially straight lines going from the hub to the, I mean, basically cylinders, but on the either on the top view or the front view, they are all rectangles going from the hub to the rim. Okay, so there are two along the horizontal axis, but then there would be four more, each making an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal axis. So this right there, then over here, and over here. Okay, and that completes the geometry of the hand wheel. Okay, is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. আর খুব কারো কোনো ইস্যু?
হ্যালো স্যার,
হ্যাঁ
স্যার, ডিড ইউ রিসিভ মাই অ্যাসাইনমেন্টস অফ অফ প্লামার ব্লক? আই এম রোল নাম্বার 133, আই হ্যাভ সাবমিটেড মাই অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট।
ওকে, ইউ হ্যাভ জাস্ট সেন্ট মি, অর ওয়েন ডিড ইউ সাবমিট?
স্যার, আই সাবমিটেড অন আই থিংক লাস্ট সানডে অর মানডে, আই প্রোবাবলি লাস্ট মানডে।
ওকে, সো আই হ্যাভ টু চেক, আই হ্যাভ টু চেক। দ্য থিং ইজ I evaluated your assignments on last Saturday, okay? Mm. And at that time, your assignment was not there.
Yes, sir. Yes, I submitted on Monday or Sunday night or Monday.
What you can do essentially is you can also send it me over the email. So I have shared my email ID in the chat. You can check. So okay. You can also send me there. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
আর কারো কোনো ইস্যু? ওকে, দ্য আদার কম্পোনেন্টস স্পেশালি দ্য স্টারস এন্ড দ্য nuts are pretty straightforward. You have already drawn plenty of them. Spindle also, I don't think it should be a problem. So what we are left with are the gland and the neck bushes, gland and what this component is, component number. So there is number 3 is a gland, and then number 4 is a neck bush. So gland and neck bush, these two are also pretty straightforward. I hope by now you should be able to draw them. So we are left with three components. One is number 2, which is the cover, okay, and number 5, that is a bridge, and then the body. Okay, we have few more components like the valve itself and also the valve seat. Okay, so these are the components which could be a little complicated, and particularly the body could also be a little complicated. So if you are able to work them out, that is fine.
So can we change the dimension of the drawing?
Not changing the scale, directly changing the dimension.
Yes, sir. Can we do it?
For what component?
For body and all, actually.
Sir,
like many dimensions are not given.
Many dimensions are not given because of that.
Yes, sir.
If the dimensions are not given, you are you're supposed to take
approximate.
Yeah, appropriate value.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
Sir, actually I don't live. Some of us are not in Calcutta, so we don't have the equipment. So we have to do on a A4 sheet on a cardboard. So it becomes very difficult to take the dimensions and even to make a straight line, sir, we have to check 3 times with the ruler.
Okay.
Yes. Similar for making the small diameters while making diameter for plumber box.
Yeah, if it is really a small diameter, you see, the first thing is, let me tell you, I'm not going to check each and every dimension of your drawing. I cannot, right? It's on a computer screen. So even if it were submitted to me physically, I don't actually check each and every dimension exactly. I mean, not with a compass or anything. So, yes, if you have a very tiny dimension, a very tiny arc, you can always do freehand. Okay, that is number one. Number two is, let's say if you have to draw a very small circle, so you can work with one of those scales which are available in the nearest shop of yours, which have circular holes, right? So you can use those. Okay, so you can use whatever is suitable. Okay, are you getting what I'm talking about? The scales which have multiple circles, so you can, you know, just put them and draw a circle inside them. So if you're working with small circles, you can work right away. Okay, so those are all are fine. Okay.
So actually, yes, I've done freehand for small circles. That's why I was
asking. Yeah. That is also fine. That is also fine. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
I believe that you couldn't find my assignment, sir. Roll number 141.
What's your roll number?
141, sir.
141. Yes.
Have you did not find my assignment?
No. When did you submit your assignment?
I submitted on Sunday evening.
Okay. The thing is, I evaluated your assignments on Saturday evening. So I didn't check after that. So can you send me your assignment also over email? Okay. I've just shared my email ID in the chat. Okay. So please check that, and can you please send me your assignment over there?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Hey, bolo.
Sir, ekta portion e oshubidha chilo.
Bolo.
Ektu drawing ta dekhaben.
Haan.
হ্যাঁ বলছি এখানে 4 ওয়েভস এন্ড 6 থিক এইটার মানেটা কি ওই অ্যারো দিয়ে একটা লেখা আছে
4 ওয়েভস 6 থিক মানে দ্য ভালভ সিট ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি নট আ সলিড জিওমেট্রি ইটস আ হলো জিওমেট্রি ওকে তার মানে এই যে ভালভটা দ্য ভালভ ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি আ সলিড জিওমেট্রি দ্যাট মিন্স দ্য ভালভ ক্যান রেস্ট্রিক্ট দ্য ফ্লো অফ দ্য ফ্লুইড ওকে লেটস সে দ্য ফ্লুইড কামস ফ্রম দিস সাইড ফ্রম দ্য লেফট এন্ড গোস টু দ্য রাইট ওকে so the valve can restrict that because the valve would be I'm trying to draw the isometric view, sectional isometric view, let's say. So imagine this is what the valve section is. Okay. And imagine this is the axis, and you know, use your imagination with Pappas' theorem. This section rotated, revolved around this axis. Okay. So, kiram dekhte hobe jinishta? Full circle. Okay. That's what the valve is. So, that means when you revolve this completely, this forms the center of the valve is empty. Okay. Center of the valve is empty, but you know, a lot of things comes inside this. So, basically, your spindle goes inside and all. Oh, one more thing. The valve actually continues to the other side also, right? So the valve is actually this section. So it's actually touching the axis. Okay. So when you revolve this, this actually continues to the other side. Okay. And this portion is somewhat like this. Okay, so this is what the valve looks like when you divide into two parts. Okay, and this part also revolves. I mean, this edge also revolves. Okay, so etari, imagine if it were to be, you know, taken a mirror image about the plane of this section, right? So that is what the valve is. So when the fluid is coming from the bottom, okay, if the valve is in there, that is over here, if it is sitting on the valve seat, so the fluid can kind of flow to the other side, that is towards the right. But if the valve is not sitting on the valve seat, so that then it can pass through the corners of the valve. That means from this sides of the valve, if it is not sitting on the valve seat, so it can pass to this side and go to the right. Now about the valve seat. The valve seat is essentially this cylindrical ring associated, basically not a cylindrical ring, but should I say a hollow cylinder. Okay, so imagine this is a hollow cylinder. Okay, and there is slight thickness on this side. Okay, so from, so this wall is slightly thick. Okay, but it's actually hollow. Okay, now through which the fluid can flow and is restricted by the valve, and when the valve is, you know, slightly above the valve seat and exactly not sitting on the valve seat, the fluid can flow through the corners of the valve. Okay, now even in that the
hello,
valve
sir.
Seat
hello ha, the last ha. Question to arekbar to repeat korun
ha to valve seat hocche ekta basically hollow cylinder. So that means the valve seat cannot restrict the movement of the fluid. Only when the valve sits on the valve seat is that the motion is restricted. The fluid flow is restricted. The fluid flow cannot be restricted by the valve seat. But then the design of the valve seat is made slightly different. So there, this extended portion of the valve is actually going inside, so this is possibly for the alignment purpose. Do you see this extended cylindrical portion of the valve? So that actually is, I believe, for the alignment purpose. So where does this extended cylindrical portion of the, again, when the sectional view is drawn, for this extended cylinder, which is very narrow, section is not drawn. Okay. So where does this cylindrical portion, solid cylindrical portion, sit inside the valve seat? So for that, there is another hollow cylindrical portion inside the valve. Okay, you can imagine that is like the hub, okay, of the valve seat. Now this hub must connect to the ring, that is the outer side of the valve seat. Okay, how did they do that? Do that is through a set of webs. Okay, it's just the same as. Now, how these waves are? Waves are individually somewhat like this, I believe. Okay, so you can see if I were to draw the isometric view, it is slightly protruded. So this is a rectangle, slightly protruded, and sorry, this is how the waves look like. Okay. So such waves are connected between the two portions of the valve seat. Ever ki to clear hocche image ta?
Ha sir.
আর কারো কোনো কনফিউশন? আর যদি কারো কোশ্চেন না থাকে, সো দেন উই ক্যান এন্ড দ্য ক্লাস হিয়ার অ্যান্ড উইল মিট অন নেক্সট থার্সডে।
স্যার, ক্যান ইউ প্লিজ শো দ্য স্ট্রাকচার অফ দ্য বডি? ইট লুকস ভেরি কমপ্লিকেটেড।
ইট ইজ কমপ্লিকেটেড। Now, in the last class, we figured out that the main portion of the body is an ellipsoid. Okay, so basically a circular arc that probably would be revolved around this axis. Okay. Which means if it is an ellipsoid, okay, I mean, I didn't see a lot of details whether or not it is an ellipsoid. I mean, you can imagine it might look like an ellipse on the front view, okay, then on the side view it could be totally flat, okay, that is also possible, right? But if with the information that has been provided, I couldn't see that it couldn't be an ellipsoid. And if indeed it is an ellipsoid, okay, so it would look the same from the major portion of the body, okay, that would look the same from the side view and the top view. And as it looks from the top view, it probably is an ellipsoid, okay. So the only difference in the top view would be that on the flange side, we should be able to see, which has not been shown, these holes. Okay, these holes for putting the bolts. Okay, or for connecting with the pipes. Okay, so this bolt holes could be seen over here, and that possibly would be in the either side. Okay. So either side of that is a flange on either side, okay. And how should they be positioned? We discussed about that as well. So so you can imagine the holes have been positioned. So this, the positioning of the holes has been shown by revolving the section, okay. I mean, you see, if the cylindrical hole were supposed to be on the plane at which the section has been taken, then you would see a rectangular hollow portion over here, where there would not be any hatching to show that there is a hole. There would not be any section, okay, of the hole. But it seems that the hole is not at this section, but at 30 degree angle. Okay, so at probably 22 and half degree of angle. Okay, so possibly how many? Achha, there are possibly 8 such holes. So this is 22 and half degree. So you need to understand how much is that distance. Okay, so if I draw that PCD circle, okay, so let's say this is the flange, and then this PCD circle has been drawn. In that, let's say this is 22 and a half degrees, and then comes your 45 degrees, and so on. Another 45 degree. So this should be total 67.5 degree. Okay. So there is a hole, and there is another hole. Okay. Now again, on this side, then in another 45 degree, there is another hole. Then in another 45 degree, there is another. But when you see from the top view, these two holes would be seen at the same position. Same thing applies to these two. Okay. Now on the top view, the flange is the same rectangle, but you are supposed to show, so that is this center line. Okay, you're supposed to show the cylindrical holes using hidden lines, right? So you can use this set of hidden lines, but how much should be this distance? This distance is actually this distance. Okay, and how much is that? That is whatever the radius of the PCD circle, that r sine 22.5 degrees, and then this distance, which is total r sine 67.5 degrees. Okay, so these are supposed to be the distances from the axis, and that's where you're supposed to draw the four cylindrical holes. Okay, so this only shows half the circle. Then there is another portion of the circle. Okay, so total 8 holes. And each pair coincides. So therefore, you will be able to see 4 such holes. Okay, and that you are supposed to draw on the either side. And that takes care of the flange part. Now, for the central portion where you have portion where the cap sits, okay, over the body, that part is very pretty straightforward. It is going to be a set of concentric circles, okay, and also you have the information of how many studs are going to sit in such in the cap, or how many studs are connecting between the cap and the body, okay, which possibly is 6. Therefore, on this diameter, okay, that is the distance between the center lines of the two studs on either side. Okay, and I hope that dimension is given. Is that dimension given? The distance between the center lines of the studs that connect between the cap and the body. Is that given? Is that information given? That seems to be not given to me. Okay, if you find it, that is fine. So then you are supposed to draw that circle. So this portion where the cap sits, okay, a series of concentric circles. So I'm trying to draw the outermost line, and then for the hollow portion, okay, there is another circle, okay, but where those studs are placed, for that you are supposed to draw 6 such holes. Okay, so that this is that PCD, that diameter I didn't find. If you find, that is good. If you don't, you can assume a reasonable value. Okay, now there are 6 of those, and if 2 of them are sitting over here, because you see this is the section plane, this center line is essentially your section plane. So if two of them are sitting over here, then the others are going to be at 60 degree angles. Okay, and that takes care of the top portion of the body. Okay, and if you assume that the body geometry, I mean this curved surface could as well be flat, okay, but we do not know how much is the curvature, and that information probably is not given. Okay, but if we do assume that it is an ellipsoid, that means a circular arc of different radius has been revolved around a smaller radius, okay, then you can assume the same radius of curvature for this one, which is given to be 224 plus 16 of thickness, okay, so 240, okay, so you can take that radius of curvature and then you can draw it, okay. Obviously the distance from the from the center line is something else, and that distance is 120, okay. So basically this is the next you should draw the another center line, okay. So let's say this is the center, okay, this point is the center. From that, take a distance of 120. Let's say this much is 120. Okay. From that, take over here another 120. Okay, this much. So, taking this one as a center, draw an arc. And taking this one as a center, draw another arc. Okay, with 240 as the radius. Okay. And then you can use a reasonable curvature to connect between a chamfering, connect between the flange and the body. That should be fine. Okay. And this is what seems to me to be the case. Okay. Now, through this hole, you should be able to see that portion of the body where your valve seat is attached. Okay, so that would be again a cylindrical geometry. So inside, you should be able to see concentric circles. Okay, but I say that how that connects to the body, that is left for you to figure out, okay, and that is still left for you to figure out how this, I'm talking about this portion, this flat portion right there, so this vertical portion, that must be a cylinder because that's where the valve seat is connected to, which is essentially a cylinder. Okay, but beyond the cylinder, how is this extended portion, which acts as a barrier to fluid flow, how that that is designed? Okay, that I am leaving again for you to figure out. Okay, so with this much of discussion, does it make a little bit more sense now with the body?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, I believe then most of the parts have been covered. Okay. Try to draw them, and if you face any further issue, let me know. Okay, so we'll meet on next Thursday, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.